What's going on, everybody? Bevaraji here. Thanks for joining the channel once again for another album review reaction of The Weeknd. The Weeknd. I've been so amped to get into more Weeknd. Abel, I think his name is. I don't know if it's pronounced Abel or Abel. I'm guessing it's Abel. But we did After Hours. Wow. We did House of Balloons when he redropped it for the anniversary or remastered it or whatever he had done. We did that. And now we're completing the trilogy. I believe these are called Thursday and Echoes of Silence. Yeah, Thursday and Echoes of Silence, which completes the trilogy. Typically, we tend to go backwards in the channel, but since we already started like the first album from the trilogy, I feel like it just makes perfect sense to finish off the trilogy, and then I guess just work our way up from there. That being Kiss Land, Beauty Behind the Madness, Starboy, My Dear Melancholy, and then we'll be all wrapped up with him. But thankfully, when I say all wrapped up, he's got a ton of music in his discography here, so there's so much more Weeknd to come, point being. And the great part about that for me on a personal level and kind of a selfish level is that the kind of music that he makes is geared in the direction of like my favorite kind of music. So I really, really love, like, R&B is my favorite genre, like alternative R&B, hip-hop, R&B, some lo-fi sounds. He kind of incorporates all of that, but with like kind of a Weeknd twist. I love really dark sounds, and that's like the definition of what he's done with everything I've heard so far. Yeah, and like really, 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 not just the dark sounds, but like dark tones and really, really deep sort of stuff that we get into where he just completely like airs himself out for his audience. And I've been such a big fan of that ever since I've started listening to him. And it's been nice to add like an artist that is in my playlist now every single day. So without further ado, I'm going to jump in now, guys. This album reaction will probably be pretty heavily cut up. If you want to get the full uncut version of me reacting to the album, 20 tracks here, you can check that out on my Patreon, along with all the other Weeknd full uncut albums we do over there, and we'll be doing as well, and the link is in the description. Without further ado, I got nothing else for you guys. Let's just dive in. You know what? We are gonna really vibe out with this, really vibe out, zone in, while of course still absolutely breaking down what's going on here. Let's do it, guys. Let's jump right in. This is it's interesting because on Spotify, which is where I listen to the music for the channel, it doesn't like break it down as far as Thursday and Echoes of Silence. It just says like disc 1, disc 2, disc 3. So I don't even know if disc 2 is... All right, so the disc 2 is Thursday, which is the one we're doing right now, and then the disc 3 is Echoes of Silence, but we're doing it all together. Let's jump right into it, guys. Lonely Star is track 1. Oh yeah. I know we just started, but he utilizes these different beats and sounds and synths so well. I don't think any other artist utilizes. I did a reaction to Melodrama by Lorde, and she had a really, really good grasp on that particular aspect of production within her album and songs. But like aside from her, The Weeknd is really just second to none with like the levels of production that go on in his music. Oh God, it all comes in together. Especially that Lonely Star concept. With that thing that slides in there. He's like trying to take her from all of her friends. This is part of why, like, whether you agree with whatever he says or not, that like that's really literally irrelevant especially when it comes to like art and music. People write from their experiences, and I've said this a lot on the channel. Like, I'm never gonna be one to like judge what someone's singing about, unless it's like just something that's kind of flagrant. But otherwise, you go through stuff, like you go through shit, and those are your experiences. You write it, you turn it into art, and you turn it into like amazing music like we have right here. I really like this, like the vibe of this. I feel like there's a reason I grabbed the drink, because it just like it just has like the vibe out sort of sound to it, where you're just like in a zone, just totally just like absorbing every single instrumental and his voice, and the way his voice trails and carries on a lot of those runs that he does, especially in the higher falsetto. And you just like completely just are vibing to it. But the fact that he is, I think, kind of getting at the fact that she should just get rid of all her friends and like give him all her attention, because she can have everything. Like, she can provide, he can provide her all these things. So just come to me. I think that that's so interesting. Oh, I love that bass right there. Man. Throw this on in the car. So he only gets her on Thursdays? I love this aspect of House of Balloons so much. He had so many outros. I love the guitars too, girl. I feel like he went through something where someone was only seeing him on Thursdays and like not the other days of the week, and it was just that, and like that was something that was getting to him and could be a lot deeper than I'm even picking up on. But that aside, like just the sound of the song and those bass, that like that bass guitar throughout the whole song, my god. I said again, like the outros during a lot of what I got on House of Balloons, I got here again, and you didn't get a ton of that on After Hours. Like, After Hours is like a masterpiece in its own right. It's a whole different vision, I feel like. But what I got on House of Balloons and then here on this track, I'm so here for that. And I can't help but look ahead and see that we have some long songs, like 7 minutes, 8 minutes, almost 6 minutes, 6 minutes. I'm assuming we're going to get a bunch more, and I'm so here for that, because his voice works so well when, whether or not it's just the instrumentals, because his choice of instrumental is always so like just great to me. But when he accompanies his voice with that, it's just a perfect fit for those outros. All right, Life of the Party, track two. Yeah. Oh, the way that comes out. That's what I'm talking about with his production. Bring it all back. Think about that, though. This is only the second time that it's picked up to this extent where this instrumental came in, yet it's been, like, very consistent throughout this song, and we're at past 3 minutes already, yet he's like built this song up so masterfully. Yeah, all back together, come on. It's so ironic because there's so much cohesion in the way that it builds up and just like put togetherness, yet at the same time, particularly vocally, he's so good at doing this thing where it feels like he just goes in a booth and he just like lets it rip. Like, he's not even thinking, he's not even trying to like make it make sense in that way. He's just like letting his vocals rip and then just flowing along with that, this wildly fucking great instrumentals that he's built. Where his, like, because he goes in those high falsettos and he does these runs and riffs that just like go so well in these songs, and just match the energy too of the songs as well. Yeah, man. Okay. Like I said, this is like a total vibe so far, which is what I knew it would be. But we're going on track three, Thursday. Sounds like chains. the same. So he was seeing someone every Thursday. Whether I understand the context or not, like of the reasoning and what was going on with it only being the one day, because obviously he's saying all about that in Lonely Star. He was seeing someone every Thursday, but also it's so cool that we're getting that same melody from Lonely Star, yet it's much more filtered, and it feels like he's like shouting and singing from like a much further away place. Kind of wish I was doing this on a Thursday now, because we're thirsty on a Thursday. I think he could be talking about being thirsty for alcohol, but he could also be talking about other stuff. I love when his voice does that so much. Like, it's in this really super tender, vulnerable place. And that's what I'm talking about before. I talked about, like, I feel like he goes in the booth sometimes and just lets it rip. And I feel like he's already got the instrumentals established. He knows already how he wants the song to sound. But then he goes into a booth and just, like, kind of lets it rip. And how whatever comes out for him, it matches his mood. It matches the tone of the song. And it matches whatever he's just feeling in that moment. And here he just decided to feel like really like vulnerable and just like really let it out. It's almost a cry the way it's delivered. And I just love when he does that so much. Yeah. I like the way that kind of breaks apart there. Again, like it's not a full outro, but it works that way a little bit. The way he gives it space to breathe. Great decision to give it space to breathe, especially the way he was riffing there at the end. Again, big fan of that song. Probably my favorite song so far, actually. I don't know, Lonely Star. We'll get there. We'll get there. The Zone track 4, this one's featuring Drake. So maybe I'll have heard it, because I feel like that just screams a single, Weeknd and Drake. But we'll see. I'll let you guys know. Just let me get in my zone. Oh, yeah. Okay. I think he's saying he needs, could be alcohol, drugs. He needs something. He needs something to get himself ready for the sex they're about to have, or whatever they're about to do, whatever interaction is about to go down. He needs to get, like, work his way into being, like, who he feels like he needs to be ready for that. I'll be making love to her. There it is. So let me keep my eyes closed. Yeah. Don't see a damn thing, but I'm a touch on. Damn, his zone is, if he can't see a damn thing, his zone is, he did say he would close his eyes. So either he just has his eyes closed, or his zone is like him being really, like, just inebriated or intoxicated. That was nice. Damn. Oh, I can't see a damn thing. Man. I can't feel a damn thing. You want to at least be able to feel a damn thing. He could be talking, though, about, like, he might not be talking like I can't physically feel anything. He could be talking like I can't feel a damn thing, like, on the inside, if you know what I mean. Man, they really made us wait for it. 5 minutes already. Bring that beat right back. All these broken hearts on that pole. And the pole dances are art, you know what I mean? Fucking artists I know. Got some new bills in the mail. Got some big favors I owe. Got some good things ahead of me. When these bad bitches let go, well, girl, let's go. Walk your broken heart through that door. Oh, got some good things ahead of me when these bad bitches let go. He's saying he's just got plenty of you, like you're expendable. He's got plenty of you waiting for him. Could also be saying got some good things ahead of me when these bad bitches let go. He could be saying, like, these women that he's hooking up with, when they let go of themselves, when they completely free themselves to hit, in this situation, Drake, like, he's like got some good things ahead of me, like it's about to be like a good night. Breath, no one need to panic. Lips so French, ass so Spanish. She don't really like attention. I don't know if she gonna manage out here, but she got me all up in my zone. Said she like the view I got in this place. We only got like, we got your standard like 16 bars from Drake. But the fact that this is so long, we waited so long, but that was so dope. It's the perfect feature. Oh man, this is so good. It's so good. It's not like go crazy and like, you know, completely go nuts over what he's talking about or like the messages he's sending or like what's going on in it. It's just like so good as far as just being the zone, as far as being able to zone into it or zone out or like grab a drink like I did, you know, and I had a feeling that that's like what I'd be getting from this and just vibe out to it. And it's so interesting because the Weeknd was so needed. I feel like there's no one else that does what he does when you think about it, right? Nobody. I remember when I did the House of Balloons reaction, I got the Dream, because I never like listened to the Dream. I don't know if I think it's the Dream or Dream. I think it's the Dream. But the Dream was like, you know, on the radio and stuff, and he did like songs with Lil Wayne and stuff, so he was out there, and he had a couple like Rocking That Thing, I think, and it's a couple others. He had some big hits. And I remember saying in the House of Balloons reaction that, like, this is very Dream. I guess some serious Dream vibes from this. And, or the Dream again. I'm pretty sure I pointed out, though, that, like, it's just a different level, though. Like, what the Weeknd's doing is a different level. It's a notch above as far as, like, the instrumentation, the beats. The vocals, obviously, like what he's talking about, the overall darkness to it. The Dream was making a lot of music that was like, this is going to be on the radio, this is going to get me like listens. The Weeknd's making music that's not so much that. It's just so much like what's important to him, what resonates with him, what he's going through. And that's the biggest difference. And we got a lot of comments in that comment section that kind of back that up. And we're on the side of that too. So appreciate y'all for agreeing with that. But, yeah, when I say that, like, this was needed, like, the Dream was the closest thing to this kind of music, but, like, it's just not close. Like, this is a different level. It's a whole different level, and it's just, the Weeknd is, like, when it's all said and done, I know we have, like, 4 albums left to do for him, but I really feel like he's gonna be one of one as far as you look back and you're talking about, like, Michael Jackson, right? Like, that's one of one. No one did what he did, musically speaking. And everything, if you want to count like the impact and the like and the legendary status and like the cult figure. Taylor Swift is gonna be another one that you look back and it's like, yeah, no one did what she did. Like, there's a lot. There's a you know, Jay-Z, Eminem. There's a lot of artists that you're gonna look back on and be like, yeah, no one did what they did. If you want to go like more pop, you can even talk about like a Justin Bieber, like the way he came out and like was dominant for the first few years. Like, no one's done that. I think that we're gonna look back at the Weeknd and just be like, yeah, no one did what the Weeknd did, especially when you talk about like stylistically and what the music sounded like and just what he provided for people that was really, really, really looking for that exact kind of thing in their life and they didn't even know it, and how he gave it to us. And I still have so much left to listen to album wise so I'm just really excited, guys, because I really, really, really have become such a big fan. All right, if you can't tell, if you see the After Hours. I think you can see it up there next to the Neo Vinyl. All right, The Birds Part 1. Okay. This is much. He added like a marching band kind of drum pattern to this. Yeah. I mean, he's being consistent. Like, you got to give him that. He's being not just consistent, like straightforward. You got to appreciate that transparency. Also, I love only the Weeknd. I feel like could pull off putting marching band type drums. That's what this is. It's like a marching band type of melody with the drum patterns that we're getting in like this kind of genre of music and make it work. And he made this work. Oh, that's so nice. Oh, and the delivery on love was intentionally done. He calls him. Don't make me make you fall in love. Oh, I like that a lot. I like that a lot, a lot, a lot. I love the way it broke down like that, and you just introduced, like, it sounded like a harp. And I love the way he made that delivery with love, because he's saying the word love as in, like, you really want to throw emphasis on that word. Like, yeah, like, that's a joke. Don't do that. And then he calls himself a bird. I didn't catch him calling himself a bird. I guess maybe it was the drum pattern that drowned that part out, or I was just vibing so hard with the song. But a bird, typically, like, you know, it's going by what you read online. If you look at an Urban Dictionary definition, it's going to say that it's like a woman that's not someone you should be with. That's a nice way to put it. And it's so interesting that he calls himself that, because he's literally saying, like, I'm someone you shouldn't be with beyond, like, just like a sexual satisfaction. So don't fall in love with me, because that's bad news for you. I promise you, I can't, like, give you what you need in that aspect. Oh, that's what, oh, man. It's so interesting. Like, this came out in 2012. It's so crazy that After Hours just completely wrecked my mind. It was just so incredible. And yet we're going back like 9 years, 10 years, and this is so good as well. It just goes to speak to, like, the level of artist that this man is, a musician. All right, Bird, The Birds, part two. You know I'm ready for this. I wonder if he'll flip it. So interesting, because this could have been all, he could have just left this as an outro to part this, because these blend in so well. This feels like the perfect cap to The Birds part one. It makes sense that he split them, because even if he left it in part one and just made it like a, it would have been literally a 10-minute song almost. So he could have just had like a 9-and-change-minute song with just the long outro, and it would have made perfect sense. So splitting it up makes sense as well, but it's just like the cohesion is, I'm going to count this as an outro. That way I could just be like, yeah, all the outros are masterpieces on Trilogy and on Thursday and on House of Balloons. Yeah. He's doing that thing I said where I feel like he just goes in a booth and lets it go. And I know he's got these instrumentals. I know he's got like the whole backbones of the song done. Like, I know, I can just tell he's got it done. But then he goes in that booth and just lets it rip. And like, whatever comes out, comes out. Like, you don't write down the way that you decide to deliver these kinds of vocals. These kinds. You could voice note them, I guess. I'm not even sure if that was a thing in 2012. But I could just tell he goes in there and just, like, lets it rip, lets it fly, whatever he's feeling like doing and riding with that. It's almost like a freestyle to it in a way. I can't believe how long I was sleeping on this guy. He's so good. Just throw this on and, like, oh my god, the way it just outros out every time. Oh, they're birds! They're birds! They're birds! They're birds! They sound like angry birds, like a big group of them, too. Yeah, I was like, oh my god, this sounds like literally crazy. Like, this, I'm engulfed in madness right now. Which is so The Weeknd. It's so The Weeknd. Okay, The Birds 1 and 2. I'm so here for it. Just the two of them I count as one song, honestly. So here for that. Alright, Gone track 7, 8 minutes. Yes, feed me. That's much different. Oh, man. Kick it to this for 8 minutes and I'll be all right with it. The Weeknd might be the hardest person to track his lyrics than anyone I've covered on the channel, like, period. Just because of all the stuff he does with his beats and instrumentals, it's just so much to keep along with, but like in the best way, because you just like, you want to by default just sit there and completely vibe out to it. And that makes it so hard to follow those lyrics, but you know you have to, because you know he's always talking about something. When I fucking was good, by the way I fucking hate it, and you'll never fucking know, I'll never fucking show it. Yeah. It's that potion that gets him in the zone. Whoa, what was he on? I'm thinking he's just smoking and doing, or drinking, but it sounds like he's on some other stuff, and from what I'm hearing here. Trance, like intransic. He just creates intransic music. I don't even know, like, I forgot I was recording from 30 seconds into that song. I'm just like lost, literally. His ability to do that is just so unparalleled. Let's go to Rolling Stone, track 8. Ooh, real messy. Not a lot of acoustics I've heard from him ever. In a life without a home, so this recognition's not enough. I don't care about. Sounds like he wants that home in there. Well, Rolling Stone, it like is literally implies someone who's constantly on the move. Nobody, yeah. The Rolling Stones were the biggest touring band ever. I'm pretty sure they went on the most tours there. That's like where you hear that line a lot, like you're always on the move like a Rolling Stone. Got me singing about a bitch while I'm blowing up with steam. Yeah, I know I got my issues, why you think I fucking flow? And I'ma keep on smoking till I can't hit another note. Wow. Oh, he's talking about singing. What's going on here? Talking about how like singing is his escape in that way, like it's as much as he has all these other things that he indulges in to use as an escape or a way to like feel more in touch with like the version of himself that he resonates most with, like music and singing is really like what like his real love. Man, it's so. The instrumental is such a change from the rest of the album, and yet his vocals manage to still, like, keep you trapped into that constant zone that he has you in, that trance. Oh my gosh, wow. That's another one of my favorites. Absolutely. Let's go to, Heaven or Las Vegas, track 9. Heaven or Las Vegas? Interesting. Like, are they opposites? Are they parallels? They're both bad places to you. They're both good places to you. Oh, that music is very, like, heavenly. Like, open up the gates. Well, I say, I am God. He just said he is God. Oh my god! The way that builds in. I think this is the least I've paused in a reaction ever. I feel like The Weeknd just has music that you have to allow to just flow. You just have to. You cannot interrupt the flow of what The Weeknd's doing here. And even when we do pause, we typically like do bring it back and rewind a little bit to catch like the flow of what we're listening to. But The Weeknd is just, you just gotta like, and it's not even from a 10-second type of flow period, like it's from the start, like the song has to start and has to end, and you just got to let it rock, and you got to like completely just take it all in. Like when that really heavy guitar started coming in, like really really sort of like they sounded really dirty, they sounded really sort of like filtered, covered, it wouldn't have hit the same without that first minute and change of just sort of the Weeknd like luring us into his usual trap of like, yeah, now I've got you, now I'm gonna like keep you here forever. I'm gonna just let it flow into Valerie. This is one of my favorite songs in the album once again. It's in my top five as of right now, but let's just go straight to Valerie. Track 10. They all flow right like into one another as well too, so nicely. I had to look the lyrics up to this one because this is something that he doesn't really, this is a lyrical place he doesn't go often. He kind of puts himself out there. Like, I know you can see through me. I know you can see through my lies. Like, talking about kind of third person, you know, certain things, comes a point in a man's life where you must take responsibility, choices he's made, certain things he must do, things he must say, like, I love you, and I need you, and I only want you. These are places that I don't hear him go a lot. I mean, I barely touched the surface with his music, so I can hardly say that. But it's so interesting to hear him go in this direction, and I'm kind of here for it. And it makes it that much more interesting that it's closing this album out. I know that he added an extra song to each one. So I don't know if this was supposed to be on this album or not, because from what I was told, they were all 9 and then he added an extra one. Speaking of that, we do need to go back to 28 because I never listened to 28 off of House of Balloons. So we'll go back to that. But yeah, it's just fascinating to hear him go in this direction lyrically. Oh yeah, okay. Put your all into it. Oh man, I love those broken sounds at the end there too. We'll get there. Man, I have my own version of my understanding of Thursday here. It seems to be centered kind of around one person, and that's how I was feeling for a while. But then he got to Valerie, and it really just messed me up as far as that thinking, because this is one person that he just could not like accept who he was and sort of his transgressions, and he couldn't like look at this person and be who he was in a lot of the other songs. And that's so fascinating. And he's just so honest. He's constantly so honest all the time. I'm so fascinated to know what the deal with Thursday is. If it's just like that's their day, or like this person, he only like, I don't know. Like there's so many ways you could go with that and theorize. But like aside from that though, it's so cohesive. It really is. Like you're just gonna throw this on, what is this, like an hour long, something like that? I don't even know. And you could just play it, put it on, get a drink like I had, and just like completely just let it own you. Let it own you. From start to finish. The way those outros are start out so perfectly when you have a song that's reached its sort of climax lyrically, and then you get to, and verbally, and then you get to where you just start, either you change, usually he softened those instrumentals for those outros, which I really appreciate, because it does a really good job to bleed into the next track, and it just works so well constantly throughout this Thursday version of the trilogy, but we ain't done. We're going straight into Echoes of Silence, because I want to just get it all. I want to get it all and like experience it, kind of whether it was meant to be experienced in this way. He put it together like this for a reason, so I want to experience it like this, the way he put it together. So we're gonna go straight into Echoes of Silence. That's the third and the ending of the trilogy, and the track one here is DD, which I assume is Designated Driver, but The Weeknd's a fucking genius, so who knows? He might switch it up on me like he did with the birds when he was the bird. All right, let's go, guys. DD, track one. Interesting, different vibe so far. Very atmospheric, but like in a much lighter way, like much lighter tone.
I know your every move, so won't you please let me be?
Oh.
I've been here times before, but I was too blind to see.
Wow.
That you seduce every man, this time you won't seduce me.
Never works on me. Is that not the most Michael Jackson thing you've ever heard? My God, when she said, you saying that, that's lying. You guys know what I'm talking about. I don't even need to say it. Wow. Wow. Even right there. This whole thing. Damn. This has got to be a whole Michael Jackson dedication, right? Wow. This is like that groupie. This is that. I mean, I assume it's someone who's got a little bit more control on his mental than your average groupie. So it's someone he actually knows. But it's someone that obviously spurned him, where to the point where, like, he knows, he's aware of that this is what they do. Like, but it's not going to work on, it might have worked on him at some point, but it won't work on him anymore. Because he knows that, like, they're waiting at the end of these musicians' sets or backstage at the concerts. Like, they're, like, you know, like, this is just what they like to do, is like hook up with musicians or like mess with them or whatever it might be. She's not gonna let it be him. And DD is Dirty Diana, he's saying. I don't know if that's her actual name or if that's a reference to something else. I like how he reached the top of his register right at the end, like when he's sleeping with this, he's sleeping with me line, and he had to go into that falsetto because he's so up there. He could have either really pushed and like completely like broken his voice or gone into that falsetto, which he did. But then he like went into a complete like 10-second riff right after that with that falsetto. It's just the Weeknd knows how to use his voice so well as a tool. Okay, strong start. Wow. Like I said, so Michael Jackson. It's impossible to not think of that when you hear that song and the way he was delivering his vocals on there and the aggression he would go into like each line and each word and the start of each word. It was just so reminiscent of MJ. But yeah, strong start. Montreal track too. He's from Canada, I was informed. So let's see where he brings it back to. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Cause I'm not as hard as you make it seem to be.
Wow, okay. Wow, wow, wow. That's so interesting. That's so interesting. That's such a complex line, speaking on the complex that he has. Because he's saying that he does make it seem like he's got that barrier and wall. Like, he's admitting to that. Like, yeah, I definitely make it seem like that. But, like, it's not as hard as I do. It's not as hard as it actually does seem to be. Like, it's doable. It's doable. Wow, that's so interesting to me. Yeah. Oh, that. That vocal on top of it. Okay, we're already like 6 seconds into outside. It just merged straight into outside. I love that song so much, actually. It's one of my favorite ones we've done today so far. And I just love how he continues to, like, on those sort of mini outros he keeps doing, he really softens the instrumentals. And he doesn't always accompany his voice to it, but he did it there, and he softened his voice along with those instrumentals. And he's just, I don't know how else to say that he's, like, different. He's just different from everyone else. Outside track 3, it's already started because it seems like it's kind of a part of Montreal with that ending. So let's see what we got.
I'll let you show me his moves, let you do what he taught you, let you reminisce how you use yourself at home.
Yeah. I'm a wreck you like a pro.
Yeah, you gon' take it like one.
Okay, wow. It's funny because this song is explicit. The last two weren't explicit. Got it. I was going to say, like, he's being incredibly explicit without even cursing right there. Yeah, it's blending right. So, okay, this album is already having a habit of blending one after the other, more so than even Thursday. And Thursday did that, but this is like doing it to the extreme. Like, this one just went right into XO, the host. I keep having this habit during this video, and this never happens to me on my videos that we do here. But I'm just like getting lost. I really just am absolutely getting lost in what's happening here. It's almost like The Weeknd's not meant to be reacted to. It's like he's just meant to listen to and absorb it and just totally go into another world. Like, that's what I want to do right now, is just go into another world with this, you know? But we're doing this. We're doing this for you guys. We're doing it. And a lot for myself as well, because I'm listening to this guy no matter what, because he's already like up there for me. XO, the host, track 4. XO. My comments were flooded with just XO. So shout out to all the Weeknd fans for that. And I guess you guys are like XO gang or XO family or XO whatever it is. But you guys refer to yourselves as XO. And I'm so here for that. I love that. So let's see what the song XO has. If it has anything to do with that or not, I don't know. Ooh. Ooh. Oh, stop.
Yeah. And if they don't let you in, you know where to find me.
If they don't. Cause if you wanna. Oh, is he the host? Is The Weeknd the host in this scenario?
Cause I got a brand new cam. Can we be OV? Can we be OV?
This man's he's a nasty dude. Alright, Weeknd, I see you, Abel. Man, we're getting more into the specifics of that on Echoes of Silence. Yeah, I want to get you at your best is POV. Like that's you at your best. Well, that reminds me of After Hours. Holy fuck. I'm trying not to think about After Hours when I listen to this, because you're talking about like an 8-year gap, like maybe even longer, because he released this on Spotify in 2012. But like, I don't know when he actually did these albums. It could have been even before that. And my guess is it was. So it could be like a 10-ish year gap. So the albums almost would have nothing to do with one another in that sense. Like 10 years, a person changes and like is almost a different person 10 years later to an extent. But that line right there is so reminiscent of the concept of a lot of the After Hours content. The difference is he said facelift. So like, times have changed. There's so many more options now. Oh, this is a 7-minute plus song. So here we go. Classic. What are we doing with it? I never know. His runs, man. His runs are always so sharp. Man, this man has the runs for days. Ooh, full stop. Yeah, every single song's transitioning. Every single one. This is Initiation. That's another one of my favorite ones. XO/the host. He's just like, every time he goes through the song and there's so many things happening constantly, but like he keeps elements of what's happening going throughout the song, but makes so many changes to other elements of the song at the same time towards the end. And I, not one single time, and I'm always honest with you guys, like if I don't like it, I say it. If I'm indifferent, I say it. If it's not my favorite, I say it. Every time he does it, not one time am I like, oh, interesting move, I don't know. Like every time he does it, it's just like, yeah, that was a great choice. Wow, this guy's a genius. And how has he managed to like do all this and have everything not only be so cohesive but be so different and be like so stand on its own-ish, and yet they all blend into each other at the same time. I am a full blown diehard Weeknd fan, and I'm so here for that. Initiation track 5, let's go.
Oh, yeah.
And we're just starting. Like, this is old. Man, I can't even imagine till we get to, like, the stuff that's to come. There's, oh my god.
Yeah.
So I caught that EXO line. He's saying a lot here. A lot of it I will have to look up. I'm gonna look it up after probably, because there's just so much. And either way, I want to know every lyric. Like, at the point of fandom I am at with this guy, especially with how lost I'm getting in all these instrumentals and production, I'm going to need to know what he's saying, like, on multiple listens. But I heard that EXO line again, which is interesting, following the EXO. And I don't believe I've heard him reference it ever before these two tracks here. I could be totally mistaken, but I don't think so. I just found that interesting. And I want to know where that originates from, the whole EXO name, or what it means. I didn't pick up on a meaning in track 4. I still am not. I know EXO is like kisses and hugs, but that seems, it doesn't seem like the Weeknd's lane. is he saying I need you to meet my boys? I got a lot of boys. We can make you right. That's what are the boys? The ex? I'm gonna look it up. I have to. Oh, and the lyrics, so again, like, we have more drinking references. We've had a ton of drinking references in both of these parts of the trilogy here. But in the lyrics, he specifically refers to this woman as the EXO, which is interesting. Like, doesn't really help me figure out what that's supposed to mean and why the fans would call themselves that. But I know you guys will let me know, because you guys are the best. And you guys are so passionate. The Weeknd's fan base is so passionate, and I'm. It's obvious why. So I'm over here and ride it out. Yeah, we know what he's talking about there. Again, we've been like straight to the point on all these songs here on Echoes of Silence. But yeah, he's saying I got a lot of boys. I want to need you to meet the boys. We can make you right. I don't know.
Yeah.
Again, it goes right into it. He said that that ooh ooh. Yeah, it doesn't even seem, because it sounded like he was saying that talk, that ooh ooh, and that XO. That's not the lyrics. Well, that part's not in it at all. Yeah, they just left that part out, because that was hardly even. I was like, this almost sounded, I don't know, but another track that I enjoyed a lot, let's do same old song, track 6, The Weeknd and Juicy J, only feature on this part of the trilogy. Not a lot of features. Like, period, from what I noticed, on his music. Interesting, good to know. Oh, wow, what makes you think you could never do me right? Wow. Damn, that's a line. I love how he carries that song out, just drags it out. I like the concept of this, because same old song is a saying. It's a saying where same old song, like, same old song and dance is another saying, but same old song is the shorter version, where it's the same thing over and over and over again. He's calling her the same old song. I guess it's, you're the same as all of them. Like, whatever. Like the groupie that he referenced back in DD. Like, you know, but I've been alone all my life. Like, I'll be good. I don't need this waste of time. Like, where were you back then? Like, whatever you were doing, who knows? Like, 8 months ago, I think he said. Yet, same old song. It's the name of the song, and like, he's literally turned it into a song. So I really like that concept. Those harmonies are nice. That, I love that line too. What makes you think? What
Right.
I mean, think about that question. Like, what makes you think you could never do me wrong? What makes you think that? Damn, that's kind of dark. His delivery is so perfect on here, too, because, like, he's, like it's the same old song. You have to kind of belt that out and carry that out like that because it is kind of an emotional. It's meant to be a bit of an emotional delivery and tone on that. He does that so well on here. You just want to emphasize that point. Like, you're the same old song. Same old. You say it over and over again. You emphasize it with the way he drags the note out.
I don't give a shit. I'm going to the strip club. I'm throwing $30,000, nigga.
$30,000.
Okay. Fuck that shit.
Again, flows right into the fall. He got Juicy J on here just to say that at the end because he didn't have a verse. I've only ever heard Juicy J on, I believe it's an Usher song, and I believe it's Love in This Club, the remix. I could be so wrong, but I'm pretty sure. I'm a big Usher fan. That's what I think. Doesn't matter, though. That was definitely him. And that was definitely his only part. And it's so cool that he actually, like, listed him on the track list when he probably didn't even have to. But that was a cool, like, dope little sort of feature there at the end where it's just, like, you're the same old song. I'm not dealing with you, so I'm just going to go to the strip club, which the Weeknd has referenced before. You got Heaven or Las Vegas. I mean, come on. And, like, I'm good. I've been alone my whole life. I'm good. I'm good with this. I'm going to go do this, drop 30K on this, and I'm good because I don't need the headache that you're giving me. So I'm with that. I'm just... The fall track 7. Is he at the strip club again? It sounds like he's at the strip club again. I want to show you how I blow money. I got show money. It's all right. I want to show you how I blow money. Talking about this is the hardest you've worked. It sounds like he's at the strip club once again. But that would make sense because these tracks bled right into each other, and that's continued to happen all album. Man, he's going all in because he's not scared of whatever repercussions are. He's not scared of that. Interesting too, because he referenced having big show money, so he's already made it at this point. So that could also reference that, like, he's not scared of, like, that fall that a lot of artists and people that when they get famous they deal with. Like that fall, like that rock bottom sort of scenario. He's saying he's not scared of that as well. He could be saying that.
But I've been good since Thursday. Yes, I've been good since Thursday.
What happens on Thursday? Oh, I need to know. Thursday's just the day he goes all out. Like, he just fucks whoever and or the one person, whatever, or goes to the strip club or does all his drinking and smoking and medicinal or, you know, drugs or whatever he's doing, pills. I mean, I don't know. Whatever he's doing, I don't know. He referenced that kind of prior. Thursday is a heavy day for my guy. Yeah. Yeah. Go all out. Just sing it out. It's just like the same old song. You gotta, like, I ain't scared of the fall. You have to, like, belt that and let that note carry out the same way he did it in same old song. And the song. I felt the ground before. I've already been there. I'll be all right. Like, I've already reached that point. Like, I could fall again. It's all right. Like, I've been there already. These outros are perfect, man. The outros, they soften up perfectly, and they give the room to breathe so well. Every single one. I've said that a few times, but I have to keep saying it. Man, I can't even imagine what he's got in store after this. Like, this is what he started with? Well, I know because of After Hours. We're going right in? Yeah, we're going. Ooh, wow, we're slowing it down for this next? That was way different. Okay, that's another one of my favorites. Easily. Wow. That might be on my top five. It's on my top five, obviously, on this version, like Echoes of Silence, but for the whole thing of the whole day, like between Thursday and Echoes of Silence, like, that's up there for me. That was everything is just All right, let's keep it going. Let's go to next and let's see what this really slow sort of start here is, if he's gonna take a different direction. We'll find out.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
That's not the first. He literally said exactly that in DD. And so is this girl here, like this new girl, trying to like take out her frustrations on her situation with Abel?
Who you trying to fool, girl? I might be 21, but I got memories to prove.
I'm glad that I got a specific age reference. This now it puts more things into perspective, although it still makes perfect sense.
And I've seen your kind before, and I know.
21 is like he's. I think the legal drinking age in Canada is actually lower than 21. But either way, like that's when you're really starting to like really learn and experiment, you know, like with substances, depending on who you are, obviously. So it just makes more sense with things.
You just want me cause I'm next.
Cause I'm next. Oh, yeah. Cause I'm next. I'm just another one. Yeah. Perfect sense. Such a different progression because of that piano.
No cheap ass pills, I used to do this for the thrill, yeah. No, you got a lot to lose, but ain't nobody here but
me. She's saying he doesn't do it for the thrill anymore. Like now it's more so just because it's just part of his lifestyle. Like this is just what, or it's just like more of an escape. Like that's such an interesting line to me that I used to do this for the thrill.
I'm too far in this game to let go, so let go.
He's too far in the game. So interesting for him to say I'm too far in this game, despite literally having just said he was only 21, or that he is 21. Because that's young. Even like from that perspective, it's easy to say that you're young. So saying he's too long in this game, too far in this game, says like that he has been doing this for a while. Like he's been dabbling whatever he's been dabbling with for a while. It's still so like this, it's so sorrowful still. Like, it's not a far reach from the other stuff he does, but, like, the guitars and the synths and the, like, the heavy bass and the dirty basses, like, the really tragic sounds he uses. Let's do track 9, Echoes of Silence. That was probably the least, full transition song to song. Yeah. And he's saying you knew how this would end, but you thought like you're scared. The thing about that is he let you know. Like he's made it clear throughout a lot of songs here that like he always makes it clear. He's always transparent.
It's gonna end how you expected, girl. You're such a masochist, and
you bring this upon. You're a masochist. You bring this upon yourself. Like I told you. I like that he says little life, like he's speaking down on his own life by saying little life. The term little means like you look down on something. So despite the fact that he like can only give her so much, he still needs her there. The last two tracks, I really love the change of pace. I really do, instrumentally. And sonically, this is track 10. I'm just gonna let it. I mean, how can I not at this point? Like this whole listener has been the definition of just let it ride out, let it play. Like don't pause too much, just enjoy what you're listening to. Because this is the start of history. Like this is the start of some legend stuff. This is how we start. 21. He did this at 21. And I guarantee this 30-year-olds, 40-year-olds, like listen to this now, like. And it's ingrained into their life. Till dawn, parentheses, here comes the sun, track 10. Third straight track, also that it's slowed down a bit. That's three straight tracks that we have gone a completely different direction sonically. But like, gradually. She came over.
I can hear it in your voice now.
It's probably Thursday too.
I don't pretend to have any shame. I
I assume he's also cheating on the same. I mean, he's referenced the fact that he has someone at home that he doesn't want to mess it up with in whatever situation he was in, or that whether he didn't want to mess it up with them or not, like they don't deserve it. However he worded it, I believe it was DD definitely, and it might have been also The Fall, but either way, like, he might be doing the same thing as them. He just has no shame about it. It's a circle. My denial keeps me on the edge of the chance that you'll stay through, and I think that's what he's saying. Whether that's exactly what he's saying or not, it's more or less what he's saying. That group of like lyrics right there really is so dark and deep to me. That's a theme with him, like lyrical, dark and deep. Every time. Oh my God, I really didn't want this to be... That's crazy, because we've been here for so long, and yet I really don't want this to be over. How about that with this guy? House of Balloons, track 10, we did not do. Let's do that right now. 28. Oh my God. It's hard to listen to this with the context of what I just went through two cohesive albums, and this is on the third one, and it's like separate also. So I'm trying to separate it like meaning wise and message wise, but then again, like, it just fits in so perfectly with everything. Only girl, did you have to gotta change my number twice a month when you could have simply kept it on the down low. Oh gosh. Wow. Oh, he's going. You keep saying there's no one. This one's so good. It's so crazy because this actually isn't far off from what I'm hearing on the other stuff, even message-wise. Man, that was so good. My God, that was good. This is a whole experience. That's what this is. It's an entire experience from start to finish. Speaking on House of Balloons as well, because that's still like it's an album I've revisited a few times since I've reacted to it. So all these together, it's just a whole experience, the best way to put it. Also, the fact that this is what he started with, and then we have so much more to come, and knowing he just gets better and better, because we've heard After Hours, and we know that's just like legendary shit type of album status right there. What I'll do is, I don't really have much to say because I said a lot, this is already going so long. I'm gonna give you guys my favorite off of each one. I'll give you six. We're just gonna do the two, as far as Thursday and Echoes of Silence. From Thursday, I'll give you six. Lonely Star, The Zone, The Birds Part 1, Rolling Stone, Heaven or Las Vegas, Valerie. What a way to close that out, by the way. Wow. And from the Echoes of Silence, Montreal, EXO, The Host, same old song, The Fall, next, Echoes of Silence, and Till Dawn, Here Comes the End. I just gave you seven from that one. Listen, this is the kind of album that you don't like skip over anything, because you just, especially with the way it went here in Echoes of Silence, where the songs just went one into the other, into the other, into the other, you're not going to skip anything. You're going to play it from the beginning. You're just going to let it run. I would do that with the whole trilogy, right? What is this? 2 hours and 40 minutes? Yeah. Start from the beginning. You just let it run. You let it run. You grab your drink. You grab your beer, your cocktail, your tea. Doesn't have to be alcoholic, whatever, it doesn't matter, because this music is so good that you just like enjoy it for what it is. And what he put together here is really something. And again, knowing that he just started here and has so much more as far as like growth and time to evolve as an artist, it's just so exciting to me. I can't wait to get into what's to come, and I'll see you all for that. And I appreciate you all for supporting me. EXO, right? Appreciate you guys.